this action, you'll be taking a 5-day no waste challenge, focusing on single-use plastics. Single-use plastics infiltrate our everyday lives in all sorts of ways, and it's really quite difficult to avoid them unless we make a conscious effort. If it's not the wrapping your lunch comes in, it's the packet of pasta that you buy, or the bag that you get given at the checkout before you can even say anything. But where does all that plastic go? Into the bin, and then into our landfills, rivers, lakes, and oceans, into our ecosystems, where that plastic never, ever actually goes away. It just breaks down into smaller and smaller bits to cycle through our ecosystems as microplastics, or it gets eaten by turtles or seabirds or other wildlife. There's even a natural phenomenon now called the Great Pacific Garbage Patch in the ocean between Hawaii and California, which is estimated to cover 1.6 million kilometers of ocean, and which contains over 80,000 tons of little floating plastic pieces. And all of this has come from households and industry throwaways as our societies have chosen convenience over stewardship of our ecosystems. There is no such thing as a way when it comes to plastic. By throwing that wrapper in the bin, we're just putting it somewhere else and nearly always somewhere that is doing damage to our planet. So, clearly, buying less single-use plastic is a very good idea. But not buying or acquiring any of it at all is not that easy. With this challenge, you are going to need to look at your daily habits and look at how you can change what you do on an everyday level to shoot for the goal of producing no waste. On a basic level, this 5-day challenge is going to involve a few life hacks. Get yourself ready. You probably have all the bits at your home now. It's just that they need to come with you each day and every day. All right, firstly, water bottle. This is a bit of a no-brainer, but still, how many times have you been caught out buying water because you forgot your water bottle? A reused glass jar or plastic bottle works just as well as a fancy metal water carrier, though we pick up metal water bottles all the time in thrift stores. Okay, now, reusable cup. These are everywhere these days and also at thrift stores, so find one that you like and take it everywhere you go. At a pinch, a glass jar with a good lid works just as well as a fancy reusable cup, and you can even slip that into a stubby holder or koozie, depending where you live, to provide insulation and to make it smash-proof. This is the coolest thing ever. Right, now, reusable bag. Find one that you can roll up small or that has its own little pouchy thing and keep it in your handbag or your day bag at all times. Always, like, do not leave the house without at least one of these rolled up into the bag that you take with you everywhere. Lunchbox. Finding a lunchbox that you love and that works for you can be a game changer when it comes to reducing waste. I've stolen my son's lunchbox for today to show you what I mean. We love ones like this with little compartments so that you have different bits of food and snacks all in one place, all separated out. This way, all the food looks appetizing without getting mushed together by the action of the day. I find that the nicer I make the lunch look, the more likely I am to eat it all up and not get tempted by takeaway food. So without going crazy, take a moment to make yourself a tasty box of goodness. If you're out and about and don't have your lunchbox or cup with you, take a moment or two to find lunch somewhere that you can sit down and drink or eat out of a non-disposable bowl, plate, or cup. This might add 5-10 minutes to your day, but it means a bunch less rubbish that you are responsible for creating. Plus, you're supporting a cafe, noodle house, or other business that provides a no-waste eating option, which is super important to have in any community. Buying groceries is another place where lots of single-use plastics come into our homes. So figure out what your options are here. Is there a bulk food store near where you live or near where you work? Can you buy pasta and sultanas in bulk from there instead and bring your own jars and bags? How about meat? Do you have a butcher you can source meat from instead of the pre-wrapped supermarket meat portions? And if you take a clean reusable container, will your butcher put your sausages directly into that instead of into a single-use plastic bag? It never hurts to ask. And the more feedback that they have and people like you asking for produce without single-use plastic, the sooner they will be encouraged to offer this as an option. This goes for your grocery store too. What about your veggies? Is there anywhere you can get your veggies from where they don't come in packets or bags? Sometimes this is as simple as taking produce bags like these to your supermarket. These are easy to make, they're super lightweight, and you can even put them through the scales at the checkout with your mandarins or whatever else you're buying. Easy. At home, there's lots of ways to avoid single-use plastics for the duration of this 5-day challenge and also way beyond. Get yourself some beeswax wraps that you can use instead of plastic wrap for wrapping cheese and covering leftover bits. There's a link below for how to make these yourself, and they're really great. Our kitchen runs on these things. There's lots of other ways you can avoid or lessen single-use plastics at home. Learn to make your own yogurt, bake your own biscuits, or learn to make your own nori rolls. Think about what you buy to eat on the regular and how you could make that yourself instead without the packaging. Start with one thing that you buy regularly, learn how to make or source that plastic-free, and then work out from there. Also, one aspect of this zero waste challenge is definitely about limiting or eliminating single-use plastics coming into your hands. But there's another aspect here to think about too, and that's the plastic that you already have. So this challenge is not about ridding your house of its existing plastic bits and bobs. This challenge is not about going out and spending a bunch of money on shiny glass and metal lunchboxes so that you can look like you've never used plastic in your life. In fact, we encourage you to actively do the opposite. Use what you have and start where you are and do what you can. If you've got plastic bags in your cupboard, reuse them. Wash them out if you need to, peg them up on the line to dry and use them again and again and again. The same for any plastic containers that you have. Figure out what they're most useful for and use them and reuse them. This is true low waste and no waste living. Using what you have rather than chucking imperfect stuff away. Once your plastic items break, figure out how to responsibly deal with them as best you can. Small bits of plastic can be poked into plastic bottles to make a building material called eco-bricks. Larger plastic items can sometimes be responsibly recycled. Take on responsibility for the plastics and waste in your household and in your daily life. This is what this challenge is about. Once you take responsibility for your plastic use and all your waste, you may well find yourself shifting in lots of ways when you make new purchasing decisions, small decisions and big ones too. Most of all, at the end of this 5-day challenge, you will be one step closer to the goal of producing no waste and have learned a bunch of new skills and maybe even made some new community connections in the process. There's a bunch of resources for you to look at below, which will help and inspire you too. Good luck.